High Table, Lower Orders by Mark Tavener.
In the immortal words of Bertrand Russell,
"No, I will put up with a very good deal, but I will not put up with student essays quoting Bertrand Flaming Russell. Bertrand Russell never understood a word of philosophy in his life. Don't waste your time reading Bertrand Russell.
Right.
You'll get more philosophy out of reading Wilbur Smith.
Right.
Or Lynn Truss. You must stop writing like a sixth former after a heavy night. You're at Cambridge now, you're with the grown-ups."
"And here I am, being burned at the stake. It was not a nice way to go."
"No, I imagine not."
"Now, this is the rack, much used in the Middle Ages on heretics and traitors."
"Oh." "And celebrity historians."
"What on earth are you doing?"
"Watching a video nasty. Sorry, I'll pause it. I got all his programmes on tape, you know. I'm an enormous admirer of his televisual technique. Such a perfection of vulgarity."
"He is dead, Gilbert. How perfectly macabre."
"Not at all. I could watch Peter on the rack for hours on end."
"The inquest is all over the papers. The death of Cambridge historian and television personality Peter Devanti was due to natural causes. A coroner's court found yesterday."
"Yes, I saw. I wonder what constitutes a natural cause in the case of a creature as unnatural as Peter."
Now, we mustn't speak ill and all that."
"What a humbug. Massive internal hemorrhaging due to a bursting of the ego. Is that a natural cause for a television personality?"
"Peter was a distinguished historian."
"Really? Distinguished by what exactly?"
"He was a fellow of this college and a celebrated historian, as are you. Admittedly, he did not produce as much original scholarship as we would have liked."
"On the contrary. He produced enough of it to demonstrate that even the award of a Cambridge fellowship can be a mistake. I always thought Peter's attempts at scholarship were a highly sophisticated joke."
"He happened to end up on television."
"By accident, you mean?"
"No, by ambition. Do we despise that at Cambridge nowadays? He brought history to the masses."
"Yes."
"And admittedly, he became rather well known and extremely rich."
"Bernard, do stop oozing hypocrisy like pus. Peter Devanti was a popular historian. Of course everyone hated his guts. What a performer."
"You know what they're after, don't you?"
"Master?"
"Bernard and Gilbert. The college bursar and the college snake. They're after my job." "Well, they're not having it."
"Certainly not, Master."
"I'm good for 20 years yet."
"Of course you are, Master."
"Mind you, being master of this college is rather like being eaten alive by sharks. The good news is that you'll be eaten very slowly. Now, where was I?"
"Dear Simon, we are holding a little memorial service in the college chapel for Peter Devanti, who was, of course, a contemporary of yours. Indeed, I believe that you were friends."
"Yes. You will, I feel sure, have read about his death, and I hope you will join us in our little homage to his memory. The death has, of course, been ascribed to natural causes, and the police have no further interest in the matter. Whilst I do not question their competence, I
would welcome a second opinion?"
Yes, exactly. I don't have a current address. I believe Simon's got some ghastly job somewhere in London."
Health and Safety Executive, Nannies, Fannies and Bossy Boots Department. Simon Harrison speaking. Buy one stupid EU directive, get one free.
"Come and see me in my office, would you, Simon? Now."
Oops. "Not a sensible way to speak to your line manager, is it, Simon?"
"I have the distinct feeling she agrees with you."
"Well, off you go."
"On a due course. What do you make of this? Whilst I do not question their competence, I would welcome a second opinion. I always rated your forensic skills, even if the Cambridge examiners took a different view."
"Were you really mates with the nation's favourite historian?"
"Oh, yeah. Yesterday, when I was young." "Huh?" "We were undergraduates together. We were both going on to fame and fortune. So he did, and I went on to Here.
The star performer of the health and safety executive.
Hardly that.
Oh, come on. Your work on that train crash was brilliant.
Well, I didn't get a promotion out of it, did I? 6 months with the major investigations department and then back here. It's funny how things turn out, isn't it? At Cambridge, I was going to be a professor of biochemistry and win Nobel Prizes. Peter was going to be famous. About the time he became famous, I was sitting in the office next door to this, being told, young man, you will in future refrain from putting jokes in the electricity at work regulations. A perfectly worthy document in itself, of course, but plainly in need of some va-va-voom. And where else would you put va-va-voom if not in the electricity at work regulations?
Do you go back often?
To Cambridge? Good God, no. Reunion get-togethers have never been my thing. Standing around surrounded by famous novelists, glittering academics, cabinet ministers, and saying, I'm Simon, I work for the Health and Safety Executive. To be honest, student days weren't exactly my happiest time. Compared with now, of course.
I take it this is about the memorial service,
Dean? In due course, Master. First of all, I wish to raise a matter of the highest seriousness.
Oh, dear. To you, everything is a matter of the highest seriousness. I suppose that's why you're dean.
Now, last night, it was my privilege to give dinner in college to a most illustrious ecumenical gathering. Senior clerics from around the world.
Was the Pope there?
His Holiness did not attend in person, Master.
I see. It was a sort of Ryman's League ecumenical gathering.
It was a most illustrious occasion. After dinner, I took my guests for a tour of the college. We encountered undergraduates in a state of the most appalling inebriation. I forbear to discuss some of their behaviour.
Do you? Good. Well, if that be all...
It is by no means all, Master. It pains me to say this, but last night, 6 student members of this college mooned the Cardinal Archbishop of Lima. I see no reason for levity, Master. The students were both male and female. The Archbishop had never seen anything like it. He was aghast. The college cannot take this lying down.
No, or bending over, for that matter.
I would merely point out to you, Master, that the affair has reached the newspapers.
Oh, Lord. Yob culture at Cambridge College. Archbishop sees seat of learning. Asked what it was like to moon the Peruvian prelate, one student replied, chilly.
The effect of such stories on potential donors to the college, to say nothing of the government.
Yes, yes, I fear you're right.
I must tell you that I intend to press for the severest penalties.
Mr. Michael Howard has the vision of a bat, the passion of a Tussauds waxwork on its day off, and the oratorical ability of a dentist's drill.
Don't you like it?
Oh, no, there's nothing wrong with it. It's terribly droll.
A parliamentary sketchwriter is allowed a certain leeway.
I have no problem with my parliamentary sketchwriter being rude about the Conservative Party. The problem is, to put it bluntly, the parliamentary sketch.
You haven't complained about my work before. Well, okay. When I first came, you told me to stop writing like a bloody philosophy graduate. So I did.
There is nothing wrong with your work. You've been a good parliamentary sketchwriter. The problem, to put it bluntly, is, that nobody's reading it. People just aren't interested in Parliament anymore. Zoe, there's no easy way of saying this. I'm going to be making some changes to the paper. I'm expanding the sports department, taking on some star writers.
Bloody sport!
Bloody sport is what our readers are reading, and as a result, and in the interest of balancing the books, I have no choice but to make sacrifices in other areas. Our political coverage is being reduced. We'll no longer be carrying a parliamentary sketch on a regular basis. Ronaldo and Rooney, interesting. Tony and Gordon, been there, seen it, done it.
Simon, I like to think of myself as a supportive manager. I don't kick butt or crack whips.
No, indeed.
We don't crack whips at the Health and Safety Executive. Now, I like to think that I lead by consensus. Do you think I lead by consensus?
Well...
Good. So, you see, that's very positive. Now, let's see if we can agree there's a problem. Simon, I think you're unhappy.
Well, I'm getting that way.
And I'm unhappy. So we've got a consensus.
Well done, us.
You are bored, frustrated and angry. And when I look at the state of your work, I'm bored, frustrated and angry. Well, I mean, I'm not angry.
Supportively angry?
That's very good. That is really, really good, Simon. We are in a consensus of being supportively angry about your work.
Can I say something?
Simon, I want your input. Your input is in a real sense...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.